Hi everyone. Windward has been out on Steam for 2 weeks now, and I've been doing nightly builds since then, so there have been quite a few changes actually. Some of them you can notice just by logging in, like there are birds, fish in the ocean, and of course the obvious snow that you see falling here. And others are more subtle. Here I have a new ship that I'm sailing. It's a corvette, a high-end light vessel, which is actually right now the most expensive ship in the game. And it brings the total number of ships in the game to 10. I've also customized it to have red sails, a different symbol, and different trim on the hull itself. You can actually do customization yourself by playing the game and finding items that let you do that. Here, for example, I have paint, cloth dye, and sail embroidery. So I can actually change my ship on the fly to look like a pirate instead. Now it's a much more frightening looking vessel. Trading has been improved a little bit as well. If you hover over towns, you can actually see not only how close they are to growing in size, like this one has 10 quests to go, for example, but there's also quantities of resources showing up as well now. So you can actually see exactly what each town needs or what it has and the quantity of it without actually having to visit the town. And speaking of trading, quite a few things were added in that regard as well. I've balanced trading a bit in terms of prices and how diplomacy affects it, but I've also added a quest for traders as well. This one, for example, buy crafting tools from Norrenworth. Here you can actually get a discount for buying crafting tools. So if you have this quest and then go to cargo and try to buy crafting tools, you can see that you'll actually get a 10% discount, which should actually be 15%. I need to adjust that. But in any case, if I now buy this, the quest completes and I get a discount of 10 to 15%. And if you ever find yourself in a situation where you simply cannot find somewhere better to sell the goods that you just picked up, you can return them back to the town where you have bought them and sell them back for a percentage of the value you'd have paid. You will not get the full amount, but it will be good enough and certainly better than nothing. Factions themselves are actually different as well now. A sojourner gets experience from discovering new towns, exchange gets extra experience from trading, and you do get experience from trading now, by the way. Valiant, of course, gets more experience from combat, and consulate gets extra experience from questing, just to give them a little bit more flavor. Stray pirates will keep appearing on maps every once in a while to challenge it, if not to take over it. So it's a good idea to place guard towers and defend your territory the best you can. Especially if you're in higher challenge areas, like this one, for example. This is a challenge 12. So I get pirates out here quite frequently. Fortunately, the defenses that I've built and the allies are enough to thwart most of them. Speaking of challenges, if you like challenges, try to make your way to a challenge level 12 areas. You can find some really high level stuff there. And my suggestion though is make use of the new ability that I've added, the chain shot. It lets you slow down enemy units quite a bit by shredding their sails. And once their sails have been shredded, they will not be able to move nearly as fast, and you will be able to get quite a few more hits on them. As you explore challenge 12 areas, you're probably gonna find some very powerful loot there. Among other things, you may find yourself with corrosive ammunition or explosive ammunition coating. Explosive ammunition lets you do roughly 35% more damage to structures, while corrosive ammunition is really good for attacking other ships or high defense targets, like in Challenge 12 areas, for example. It lets your regular cannonballs ignore the first 10 points of defense, which is very, very useful to have. As you find yourself adventuring, you'll be getting experience, and you can examine how close you are to the next talent point just by opening up the talent screen. There's now an experience bar showing you exactly how close you are. Pardon me a second while I kill these. It's a good idea to stay out of their line of fire, not just take them head on, because they do have some pretty powerful weaponry. Especially if they get you with a chain shot, shred your sails, and then make you move very slowly, they can easily drop a poison cloud, which would reduce your defense and essentially make you dead. As you find yourself with allies, like these guys for example, you can actually direct them somewhere by opening the map, right-clicking on it, and saying send followers there. What they're gonna do is just, they're gonna head to wherever you sent them, and if they happen to encounter something on the way, they will fight it. If not, they will proceed directly to the target and do the obvious, like capture it for example. One of the most important changes to the game, though, was with the multiplayer fixes. Quite a few bugs were resolved in multiplayer, and it should be a much smoother experience now. Some people have also been running a multiplayer server and playing on that. So for those who wanted more of an MMO-like experience, there is now something you can actually enjoy as well. And of course, you can run your own dedicated servers if you like, and invite people to join you. The actual server for Windward comes with the game itself. It's an executable called WW server, and you can launch it either in Windows directly just by running it, or on Linux or Mac OS by using Mono. There are more details on the forum. PvP has also been added to the game, so if you want to have massive 4-on-4 team fights, now you can. In order to start PvP, all you have to do is enter an area that does not belong to you, like for example this one is majority taken over by Exchange and I'm playing Sojourn. So what I can do is enter this kind of an area and then contest it by using this button right here. If I contest it, this area will become a free-for-all essentially for 15 minutes. At the end of the 15-minute period, someone is going to be declared a winner and will take over the zone. Here my team is about to take over the zone that I challenged earlier, and we still have 11 minutes remaining. It was only easy because I was in a low level area and I happened to have a high level ship, and all the allies on your team is, well, they're essentially going to copy your equipment. So the better your equipment, the better the equipment is going to be of your allies as well. Well, that's about it for this video. If you want to read the full list of patch notes, you can actually find it linked on the Steam forums. And it lists the changes for every single day since the release on Steam. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.